Welcome, welcome, welcome to Inner Works, where everything starts within us. For this week, let's start off the day by creating a safe space where we can speak our truth and live our authentic lives. I'd like to share to you this quote. Remembrance of things past is not necessarily the remembrance of things as they were. So this was in the book of Mr. Marcel Proust, which is In Search of Lost Time. So Marcel Proust is a French novelist, critic, and essayist. He was considered one of the most influential authors of 20th century. So this is exciting for me because I'd like to introduce to you the Rashomon effect. So the Rashomon effect is where individuals give significantly different but equally believable accounts of the same events. Well, to simplify what it is perhaps what I can think of is, like, if there's an elephant and you have three people, one is in the front, one is in the middle, and one is in the end, or in the back or in the bottom rear of the elephant, all three of them can describe the elephant, all believable but totally different from each other, but still the same elephant. Like, the first person can or will describe the trunk, and then perhaps the second one who is in the middle can describe the body or the belly or the tummy of the elephant, or, and the last one is the tail. They are all describing the elephant but totally different. So that is the Rashomon effect. So if we're gonna apply this in our everyday lives and events, truthfully, the complexity of truth varies as we rely on our own memory. You know, like they say, like, there's different versions of stories. So that's exactly what it is. If we rely on our own memories because of our individual biases, so we can tell the same event but totally different versions from each other. So if, example, you know, like, if we're gonna go in a roller coaster ride, the same roller coaster ride, you know, like, I might find it fun and exciting, but you might find it very scary and traumatic. So that is the Rashomon effect. It actually can resurface to anything in our lives, like what in my example, like in events, or even in, you know, like, memories and how we recall, maybe good or bad, but different version to actually what really happened. But, you know, what interesting about this is, you know, like in science, the lowest form of evidence is eyewitness. But in the court of law, the highest is eyewitness testimony. Isn't that interesting? But I suppose if we are really going to ponder about it, about this, is what is truth anyway? We all have our different truth, and our memory more often always betrays us. So this is it for me. I hope you find that interesting and valuable. So if you feel like sharing, commenting, or joining us in JhermiNATION, please do. This is MIMI MILLI, sending my love and light to you. See you next week!